Hi everyone, it's me again, Angela Oi Chung. Today the topic is intestinal metaplasia. Intestinal metaplasia is a medical condition that occurs when the normal lining of the stomach, also called gastric mucosa, undergo a change in cell type and start to resemble the lining of the intestine, which is also called intestinal mucosa. Let me make it simple. Intestine cells grow in the stomach, which is not supposed to be there. This change in cell type can occur as a result of chronic irritation or inflammation of the stomach lining, such as from the infection of the bacteria, which is called Helicobacter pylori, which is a major cause of gastric ulcer and gastritis, and other factors such as smoking and certain diet habits. Intestinal metaplasia is significant because it has been identified as a potential precursor to gastric cancer. Individuals with intestinal metaplasia are estimated to have a 6 to 10 times higher risk of developing gastric cancer than those without the condition. The risk is further increased in the presence of other risk factors, such as family history of gastric cancer, smoking habits, or poor diet. It is important to notice that not all cases of intestinal metaplasia will progress to cancer, but monitoring and appropriate management are essential to reduce the risk. A GI doctor may recommend a regular upper endoscopy to monitor any changes in the stomach lining over time for patient diagnosis with intestinal metaplasia. Prevention and management strategy may include lifestyle modifications such as stop smoking, the use of medication to treat H. pylori infection, and diet changes. Even though it has no specific diet can completely prevent intestinal metaplasia, certain type of food has been associated with an increased risk of developing this condition. Avoiding this food may help reduce the chances of developing intestinal metaplasia. Studies have shown that consuming large amounts of processed or red meat may increase the risk of developing gastrointestinal problems, including intestinal metaplasia. Consuming food high in fat and calories, such as fast food or fried food, has been associated with an increased risk of developing gastric inflammation, which can lead to intestinal metaplasia. Smoke or a pickled vegetable contain nitrate, damaging the stomach lining and leading to inflammation. Both alcohol and tobacco have been linked to an increased risk of gastric intestinal problem, including intestinal metaplasia. It is best to avoid or limit the consumption of this product. Overall, intestinal metaplasia in the stomach need close attention and ongoing management to reduce the risk of gastric cancer and other complications. An upper endoscopy can be surveillance for patients with a higher risk of gastric cancer due to intestinal metaplasia. Thank you for watching my video. If you like it, please give me a like. Also subscribe my channel if you want to have GI disorder information. Next topic is gastric cancer. See you next time. Bye bye. Thank you.